Hello everyone, I'm Cindy Cowan. Wow, we made it through the entire summer together. Thank you guys for joining Omnicultural TV Fest pre-show with this week's selections. Tierra Beach is a futuristic dramedy about a college freshman on summer break of 2069 who returns to his racist home space colony and kindles a romance with a Hispanic girl, which gains the town's attention. It's created by Mike Allott, starring Noel G from Fast and the Furious. He's also the chef on Fresh Off the Boat, on ABC, and much, much more. With an amazing cast, you're gonna get to meet right here, right now. Your host, Kiki Melendez.
Hello and welcome to Omnicultural TV Fest pre-show with one of our official selections, Tierra Beach. The whole cast is here. Yay!
Hey, what's up?
Hey.
Oh my God. Thank you so much, Cindy Cowan, for that beautiful introduction and for being here with Omnicultural TV Fest. I am very proud of this new selection that we have. It is a scripted dramedy, I should say, entitled Tierra Beach. It was created here with us today. We have the cast members and the creator, Mike Gallant, who is a director known for Duchess of Cancun. And I'll take your dead.
I'll say that I was the editor on that one. I wasn't the director. I don't want to steal that.
Okay, good. You're such an honest guy. Very honorable of you. And the upcoming The Oak Room and Vicious Fun on HBO Max. And he wrote, produced, and directed and edited. My God, what else did you do? Did you do the food? What
I
is it?
Everything. Craft
service? Did you do craft service? Of Tierra Beach. We're going to find out a lot about Tierra Beach. And with us also is Elizabeth Ruiz Quevella. She is known for Unsolved, the murders of Biggie and Tupac. And she has 550,000 followers on Instagram. You go, girl. What are you doing on that Instagram? What are you doing there?
So I basically started my social media platform by doing comedy videos. And I would, same as Mike, I guess, right, produce and direct my videos and edit my videos as well.
Definitely, you have the charm of acting, from what I can see from Tierra Beach. And we also have Andrew Yakel, actor, known for Mindhunter and Gutterbird. How are you?
Good, how are you?
Okay, and we also have Iroko Anyogi.
My name is Iroko Azikwe Anyogu.
Coño! Can I just say I-A-E or something?
You can really just call me Roko. That's what most people just call me.
I love it. Thank you. Shh. Ay, Dios mío, I was sweating already. I'm like, how am I going to sound that? Okay, great. So this is a great cast. And also with us is one of the stars of the show, Noel G. You might remember him from Fast and Furious, Training Day with Denzel Washington, the tax collector, the chef on Fresh Off the Boat. He's got Mayan MC. I mean, what hasn't he done? Welcome, Noel G.
Thanks for having me. Hi, everybody. What's up? What's cracking?
This is an awesome project. So tell me, what was the inspiration for Tierra Beach?
I wanted to just come up with a new idea. I actually watched Dazed and Confused, I think, while I was waiting around. And I just thought this would be a really cool idea if instead of a period piece for something, you know, from the 70s, what if we went in the exact opposite direction? And did something in the future, but kind of grounded it so that everything feels familiar to what we already know. It's not too didactic and, you know, it doesn't feel like Star Trek, even though it could take place in that sort of type of world. And I just thought of the stuff kind of going on in the world right now, this might hit home for some people. And I just thought doing it in a different context in the future instead of now, just to sort of mix it up and
Oh my God, that's exactly what I thought was really cool, because it was very original, the way that you kind of created this world and the kind of like the future, but you still felt like, you know, it was urban, and it was, that's what I think is so unique about this project. So that's a great thing. And how did you like the role when he suggested, or did you audition for the role? How did it all happen?
So the role came to me. He actually tried to audition one of my friends, and
you were cheating on her, Mike.
Well, so she responded to an online audition, her friend, and then I was like, oh, she'd be great. And then she, once I told her about the role and it was Spanish speaking, she's actually like, no, I highly recommend this friend of mine. And then Elizabeth popped out an audition.
¿Hablas español?
Sí, hablo español, soy cubana.
Ah, cubana. Yo crecí en Miami, so I'm like a cubana. So how do you love playing this role, girl? Because you did a great job. It was very authentic.
Thank you so much. I actually really loved it because, first of all, the storyline of it, it's telling a story of, you know, kind of feeling secluded and stuff like that. And I think everybody can relate to that. So at some point in your life, you felt like that. And, you know, my whole relationship with my father, you know, there's a little bit of a backstory on that because I have a certain relationship with my father. It wasn't too difficult to do a lot of character building, you know?
Right. It wasn't a far reach, you don't think?
No, it wasn't.
Oh, wow. That's really cool. So, Noel G.
It was a stretch to, you know, to play a dad and, you know, do what I did. It was a little bit of a stretch and, you know, character-wise with my acting. So, but again, I have kids in real life, and so I kind of use that to use it in the film, and that's kind of how I help bring the character to life.
Like, there's a lot of stuff in there that's actually taken from my wife's family. Like, her dad really, or her grandfather really played with Mickey Mantle, and he was like a professional baseball player. And so I saw the character differently before I cast Noel. Like, I saw him not really as like street and like street smart like that, more of like a farmer type. But once we got Noel, I realized, I was like, this was by far the best decision.
Right? Awesome.
He had like the perfect swagger and the perfect sarcasm.
Sometimes it's harder to play those roles when they're so close.
Yes.
It's harder, you know?
Yes, especially in certain scenes, it's like, you have to go there, and then it's like you do multiple takes on it. Like, okay, take two, we're gonna do it again. And it's like, okay, I gotta go there again, you know? So it can be a little, you know, you have to like really work on your mental health for stuff like that, but you really enjoy it. You have to enjoy every step of it, you know?
Exactly. One time I had to play Kiki Melendez and I couldn't do it.
Oh no.
So, and tell me a little bit about your roles and how you feel about them, Andrew. What did you think about your role and how did you connect?
I don't know. I thought my character was kind of getting to introduce everybody, because we kind of follow my guy around and I bump into the old college friends and then Elizabeth. And then unfortunately we bump into Rocco and his,
Chad.
I actually have a weird backstory to why his name is Chad, because I thought of that place as almost like a reverse Wakanda, where it's like a really beautiful isolated place, but instead of people being nice, they're, you know, they're terrible to outsiders. And when we casted Rocco, I think the original name was Chad, and I was like, well, what if, or sorry, Chester. I was like, well, what if we named him Chad, kind of like as Chadwick Boseman, but like the bad.
How did you like playing your role? What did you connect with it?
It was really exciting because that was my first villain role. Like, that was the first time that I could actually connect with like someone that was really like, you know, they say never judge your character. And so when I first read it, I was like, dang, like he's really a, like, why is he like this? But I really enjoyed it because like most of the roles that I get, I usually play like someone that's nowhere near mean or stuff like that. So like that one, I could really get in depth. And I remember a scene that I had with Elizabeth, and Mike pulled me to the side. He said, hey man, I need you to go in the garbage. Just get nasty and dirty with it. And I was just like, well, all right, let's get it. And then just
I loved it.
Noel G.
I'm so happy I got to be a part of Tierra Beach. And that's what's up, because if you get to be a part of any project, big, small, or medium, it's a blessing in itself just to be a part of a project, period.
If you were able to get this project on the air, get it distributed, do you see it on Netflix, or do you see it on a streaming service or a network?
Yeah, so I think this could definitely work as like a 12, like an 8 to 12 episode of like a 60-minute drama. A streaming service, like I wouldn't want to be hindered by, you know, a PG-13 rating or network restrictions, because I think this story works best, as it did in the short, showing off, you know, the raw emotion and, you know, the dialogue between people in those communities and, you know, and even the vitriol that can come towards them from other people. You know, I don't really like the idea of softening that. So I definitely see it as, you know, being in that
space. Absolutely. And with all, and it's beautiful because you have such a diversity in your cast, which is what everybody is looking for. And that's one of the reasons that you were selected. Because we celebrate diversity with Omni. That's why, you know, we named it Omni, because we want to include everybody. And it's so hard to do that. But when you do it, it always comes out beautifully, you know? It always meshes together perfectly. So who's doing what? Tell me, baby.
Right now, currently, I'm on set in South Carolina. We're shooting this series called Complicated.
So tell us a little bit about that project.
The project, it's really complicated. It has like a lot of different entanglements in it and everything like that. So like the role that I'm playing, I'm pretty much like a nice playboy who I start off with like a lot of women and stuff like that.
I
and
love it. Now,
real stretch, right, Hiroko?
And I end up running into this beautiful female who has like all of her stuff together. Yeah. And with me, I'm everywhere. Zay is everywhere. His name is Zay Foster. He's everywhere with it. And when he finds her, she's almost like his ground. So he can really stay grounded with her. So he's pretty much pursuing her.
Congratulations.
And thank you. Thank you.
Andrew, what are you up to? What after Tierra Beach?
Not up to much. I'm I just had a movie that I starred in called Gutterbug come out.
You look like you're quarantining. Are you quarantining?
I am not. No, I mean, I've been working at various jobs ever since the quarantine started. I really never quarantined.
Noel,
I've been blessed. You know, I've had a project that I finished. Well, a couple projects that I finished before the pandemic. So one of them just came out recently, The Tax Collector. It's with Shia LaBeouf and George Lopez, Conejo, and a bunch of other cats that are up in that joint. So that's, you know, I got some other projects. I just did one with Jamal, who played Biggie Smalls in the Notorious movie with Puff Daddy. So I've been blessed. I'm actually working on a movie right now. I'm flying out to Texas, Dallas. And so I'm working on another project. So I've been blessed to stay busy, you know. And then, you know, doing the car shows and stuff like that keeps me busy in between. So it's been a good life. I can't complain. I complain, nobody listens anyways.
Wow. I get you, baby. I get you. And what about you, mi amiga, Elizabeth? What are you up to?
So I worked on a film called Dressed to Kill that it was produced by Damon Dash and Kanye West. And now Damon actually asked me to work on another film that he's working on. It's actually a zombie movie. So I have a role in that, and we start shooting on Tuesday. So I'm really excited about that.
Have you seen how different production is now?
So crazy.
Yeah. Like literally every few minutes, they're over there checking your temperature, making sure you hand sanitize. As soon as we stop cut, mask right back on and everything.
I'll be able to tell you that after this first film that I'm filming, because tomorrow when I fly into Texas, Dallas, the first place they're taking me to is the sheriff's station. They'll go get a COVID test to even allow me on set. So, you know, there's a new thing right there that I've never done before in my life, in my career. So, you know, new world, new life, we'll see what happens. But, you know, I'm just kind of floating with the program until it's time not to float with the program. And for that one, you'll just have to watch my IG and see what I mean by that. Because, you know, I just say this with all due respect. I'm a believer in the COVID. I know that the COVID is real, but I just don't believe it to the extremity of what they're making it out to be.
Yeah, it was so funny because my friend is on the set of the number one sitcom in America. And he was like, you can't even go near craft service. They have to bring it to you. He goes, I don't mind that because I'm sitting in my trailer and they and some people said that we're going to have shorter hours because they don't want people getting sick. So, you know, maybe this will pay off at some point. So that's awesome. You guys seem like you're all shaking and moving. And Mike, do you have any other projects that are going on?
Yeah, so I just want to give a shout out to the producer of Terra Beach, who really brought the whole thing together. Like when I walked on set, so I live in Toronto, so I flew down to Florida to shoot. And when I walked on set, I literally didn't know one person, I don't think, on set. Besides him that I had met maybe a month before that or a week before that, but he did a really insanely good job bringing everyone together. So, and yeah, so he and I actually have been working on a documentary that's a football documentary that's going to be releasing at the end of this week. I've been an editor on a MOW and another one we just finished, another one starting next week. But the things I am excited about is I edited a bunch of features at the end of last year that have been getting into a bunch of festivals and one like best Canadian feature at Fantasia.
This is an exclusive. I was really trying to hold on to trying to do Omnicultural TV Fest live because what people loved about the festival, because our partners, the National Association of Television Program Executives, NATPE, it was so good because they brought the buyers and I brought the filmmakers and everyone got to really network, you know, and get to know each other and make great contacts. So I was like, I don't want to do it virtually. We have no choice. So yeah. Now we are going to have Omnicultural TV Fest and it's this really cool virtual event that you are will be avatars walking through the festival, meeting people, networking.
Wow.
You'll be able to go into the theater and watch your movie. It's gonna be so cool. So we That's are so launching this and I'm like, oh my God, this is like a dream come true. It's like virtual, but you get to meet each other, you get to talk to each other, you get to see who's in your movie, you know, who's watching your movie. You know what I mean?
That's interesting.
That's really good.
Isn't
That's
that amazing. Cool? So it'll be so much fun. You'll all have your little badges. Everyone can go on stage and talk and everything.
Wow.
So cool. Yeah. So, and also I wanted to let you know that I sent your project off to Shorts TV. Cross your fingers.
Yeah.
Let's see. They might buy it, you know, because they love all our shorts. So when I see something really good, I send it to them. So I just sent it to them last week. And they got back to me and said, we're definitely going to watch this after the holiday weekend. So hopefully we'll get a sale.
Hey, there we go. My wife will be happy to hear that.
I know. So Noelle, you have been so successful. You have been in so many shows. My God, you've done it all. What can you tell our viewers about this business and something that you wish someone would have told you?
I wish I could tell them that, you know, peace of mind is being in your purpose. And so if you're not in your purpose, you'll never have peace of mind. I always tell people the only way they can fail in life is if they quit in life. So if they never quit, then they won't fail. It took me 8 years to get my first movie. It was no walk in the park. It was no duck walk. But I always think about, what if I would have quit it on that seventh year? Where would I be today? If I would have quit it on that seventh year and said, enough's enough, throw in the towel, give up, call it a day, I wouldn't be where I'm at today. But on that seventh year, I kept on pushing. And finally, in my eighth year, I got my first film, and here I am today. So anyways, my point is, if I could do it, some kid from the street, you guys could do it. And I take no credit for this, no credit for this. My boy, Richard Montanez, who was the creator of Cheetos, started off as a janitor, and now he's a multi-billionaire. He has Hot Cheetos. He created Flaming Hot Cheetos. And long story short, he always says that a lot of people used to tell him that you started at the bottom as a janitor. And he goes, no, I didn't start at the bottom. He goes, I started at the beginning. And so I started at the beginning of my journey, just like you're starting at the beginning of your journey. So that's why I encourage people not to quit. And if you don't quit, you won't fail, because you're starting at the beginning of your journey, which is always going to be tough. But as you continue to push and push and push, you'll make it through. And your dream can become a reality like my dream became a reality. Again, I take no credit for that. Richard said that, but it's something that I repeat to this day because it hit me so powerfully that I think it's something that needs to be spread and heard.
It's a good answer, Noel.
I always say God first and the rest will work itself out.
Thank you for joining today. Have a wonderful weekend.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks,
everyone, Katie. Subscribe to the channel. Subscribe to
make sure you subscribe.
YouTube. Subscribe. Love you guys.
Bye. Right.
Love you.
We have great news, everyone. Omnicultural TV Fest will be interactive via Streamworld, inhabited by your very own avatar. You and all your network will get to mingle, attend panels, ask questions, and even set up private meetings. It's gonna be huge. More info coming soon. Meanwhile, save the date, December 8th, 2020, for our virtual Omnicultural TV Fest. See you guys soon.
At Omnicultural TV Fest, we believe that great content is and always will be diverse and inclusive.
I'm Doug Williams.
I'm Ada Lucla Williams.
Hi, I'm Corey Martin Craig.
My name is Diana Hernandez.
Hey, I'm Cindy Chu.
Hi, my name is Kate Rose Wilgren.
Hi, my name is Howard Green.
Hi, I'm Amanda Dash.
Hi, I'm Gordon Green.
And I was winner of the 2019 Omnicultural TV Fest.
My project, To Be Me, won Best Sizzle Reel at the 2019 Omniculture Festival.
I'm the winner of Best Scripted Comedy for my TV series, Queens.
I would like to thank Kiki and Sydney and the entire team for putting on an incredible, wonderful, amazing, much-needed festival.
I believe that Omni TV Fest is really onto something and are the epitome of what diversity should look like.
We are inclusion and diversity. She's Hispanic, Latino, and I'm black.
We are here to show our talent, to show what we want to create and show the world.
Let's do this together.